Welcome to View from the Top. Thanks for joining us. I'm Modile Sharafa Isuf. Banking clearly is critical to efficient mobilization and allocation of financial resources for individual, national, and global prosperity, and it has, as we know, lending at its nexus. However, change is now the common narrative in banking. Oh, well, okay, not that change. It is the three interlocking arrows affecting all retail banks: regulate, revise, and re-envisage. Regulate still resonates as the CBN continue efforts at policing the system without stymieing economic growth. Equally challenging is revise, as traditional players work out their roles as customer expectations change rapidly. Further impetus comes from startups and non-banking disruptors who aim to re-envisage banking. Experts say the danger of a systemic banking collapse has all but passed, but the regulators and prosecutors have discovered that finding banks is popular and profitable. Extreme risk-taking has been tempered by compliance, cost, and fair. And retail banks remain caught in the crossfire between the desire to protect depositors' funds, the need to deliver essential services, and the profit imperatives. Can banks survive the onslaught? Yes, but if they change, and change quickly. One bank which seems to understand the imperative for change is UBA. And today I'm being joined by UBA's Managing Director, Mr. Phillips Odroza. We will be discussing change and more. Mr. Odroza, thank you for joining us on View from the Top.
Thank you so much, Modele.
Here's a quick biography of my guest before we settle down to our conversation. Mr. Phillips Odroza was born on August 24, 1962. He got a first-class degree in civil engineering from the University of Lagos in 1983 and a postgraduate degree in civil engineering from the same university in 1986. He also has an MBA from the University of Lagos and an AMP certificate from the Harvard Business School. Mr. Odroza started his career in 1987 with the International Merchant Bank PLC and moved to Diamond Bank Limited in 1991, where he rose to the position of Executive Director of Business Development. He became Acting Deputy Managing Director, Reliance Bank Limited in 2004, and a year later became co-acting CEO of STB PLC before the bank was merged with the old UBA PLC in December of the same year. Phillips Odroza has been UBA Group Managing Director CEO from August 2010 to date. He is a fellow Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria. Right now, banks, as we pointed out, have to adapt to regulatory, customer, and technology changes. Which is the most compelling and why?
Well, three of them are very, very important. First and foremost, the regulatory aspect is very, very key. And as a financial institution, you must comply with regulatory pronouncements. Most importantly is the area of governance. And what I normally tell people is that no matter how strong your financials are, if you don't have the right governance, it is just a question of time and you will go down. So beyond looking at capital, looking at liquidity, looking at management, and so on, governance is very, very key. And why is it so? For a bank, your major role is intermediation. And basically what you are doing is taking deposits or money from the people who want to save it and giving it to the people who want to borrow and use it to finance their operations. If you do not play this role properly, you will find out that you are going to run into problems. Now, where will this problem start from? First and foremost is the liquidity aspect. If you take deposits and you lend out all the money that you have taken, you find out that your liquidity is actually constrained. The implication is that a depositor who comes to withdraw money will not have, you will not have the liquidity to be able to meet that need. On the other hand, if you start growing your loans, which in the banking terms we call credit, without control, you just find out that you start booking bad loans. and so on. So it is a balancing act, and you have to manage it carefully.
Many of the banks are exposed to the oil and gas sector. They have a lot of money hanging in that area. How is this impacting business at UBA?
I will say this. Exposure to the oil and gas sector is not really bad. If you look at it today, the oil and gas sector actually generates about 90% of our foreign exchange in Nigeria. Oil and gas is the main driver of the economy as far as Nigeria is concerned. And as such, it is normal for banks to lend money to those that are producing the crude oil and so on. What you see has happened is that the price of oil has come down significantly. And in doing your credit analysis, the loan analysis, you look at a particular oil price, and what you are telling yourself is that if the oil price continues to be at this level over a period of 3 years, over a period of 5 years, the loan will be fully liquidated, will be fully repaid, and so on. So when the oil price dropped, and it started around 2014, the most recent one, when the oil price started dropping from $118 a barrel to the level where we are today. And mind you, in February this year, it went as low as $28 a barrel. What has happened is the exposures to these oil companies, actually, they could not generate sufficient cash flow to meet the repayments. So if you have been repaying on the average, for instance, about $5 million on monthly basis, you find out that your income, your revenue as an oil company is going to decline with the decline in the oil price. So you'll probably be generating less than $5 million. So for you to service the loan means that you need to go and look for money elsewhere, or you now have to ask for a restructure, which is what the companies have done. The oil assets are still in the ground. They have not disappeared. So instead of repaying the loan over a period of 5 years, you find out that the loans are now being repaid over a period of 7 years or 8 years, as the case may be.
Someone also said that the federal government and its inconsistent monetary and fiscal policies and the attendant hostile environment will render some genuine borrowers unable to pay. Do you agree with that?
I really don't agree with that completely. Yes, we have had unstable policies for some time, but not necessarily monetary policies only. In fact, in the economy, you have the monetary policies, which are driven by the central bank, and then you have the fiscal policies, which are driven by the government. And there must be an alignment between the monetary policies and the fiscal policies for the economy to run properly. And whatever central bank is doing in the monetary side must be complemented by whatever is going on in the fiscal side. So the Ministry of Finance, the taxing authorities, and all the other agencies of government, they must work together with the central bank so that there is that alignment between the monetary policies and the fiscal policies and so on. You don't want a situation where you have a policy somersault. So if we have the monetary policy that is in sync with the fiscal policy and there is consistency, we are not going to have problems in the economy as far as loan repayments are concerned.